One thing I like to do is climb up this really tall cliff and just imagine what it would be like to fly off of it. And once my brother and I and a friend were up there, and I said, hey, let's write down our deepest, darkest secrets on a piece of paper and throw them into the river as airplanes. But before our friend could throw his, we tackled him and snatched away his paper and opened it up and saw that the ding-a-ling had drawn this.
Fucking cock, fucking dicks, fuck! Fucking shit, fucking.
These assholes can't piss all over purity like this.
The stories of Gary Lutz are like those airplane confessions. You feel sick knowing that there are others out there whose own personal skid marks are real similar to your own, except Gary Lutz takes it to extremes and just runs with it. He took his first steps in the middle period of the quarterly with these trifling little poems. Some of them didn't even have any content. It was just a title. And then he started publishing under the pseudonym Lee Stone. Then on October 29th, 1996, he walked into Barnes & Noble and saw on the new fiction table that the stories had finally solidified into this sculpture that at the time you had no idea how hard you would be worshiping them. These stories are actually more like case studies of relationship hell, where the loneliness is so great that these couples, they don't really care what parts they have to connect with, not really fitting with each other, because they'll still push all the way through to whoever is next in line, but then also start impersonating or becoming the opposite sex of whoever they were just with from that residual contact. But you start to wonder, would he ever drop an even bigger load, like something the size of this, maybe a novel that takes place completely outside of his comfort zone, like in Africa or Greenland, or like this book here about this African who actually went to Greenland, so that he can get inspired again on the same scale as that first encounter with the Grand Wizard, the man famous for carving up the words of his disciples. Some of which, though, when they outgrow the reach of his fingerprints, actually start to unravel and regress. But in Gary's case, he reached a whole new category. Considering that this particular method would result in stories about failure to mate or domestic discord, but you can see that that's not really the case when you look at writers like Martin or Person, whose gaze is directed more outward, you know, toward the world. But I think that inward direction was the direction that was most favored by Captain Fiction, who you can see has certain guidelines that Gary Lutz fits perfectly into. Like when he describes the taste of cum or pee or poo, that he's really not that far off. But at a certain point in his career, it looked like it would have to take somebody with a certain amount of pull. In this case, somebody who owned a dot matrix printer and a Xerox machine and a long stapler to be able to step up and put his work out there. Then Calamari put out this collection where, of course, we see the same tropes at this point. The almost Diane Williams-like concern about swept up hair and subordinate cities and that disappearing voice. And people going through each other and changing gender. But here, it's almost like this collection goes to even greater lengths. And it's not just in actual length, because this contains some of his longest work, but it just goes deeper in documenting those, you know, like sidelong, fleeting peculiarities about life, but just pushing them up front and string of sadnesses that just they get
to
star
in and clumpy. It's like the stories here have spent more time marinating in his balls.
Holding up that skirt of loneliness.
Then I got this in the mail. It's like something you find in the bottom of a cereal box, and you know, but it's kind of handy. You can carry it around in your back pocket. Kind of need one of these though to be able to read it. And I think that the author was actually on board with this shrinking of his work. I think it was a physical representation of how he felt.
I think that's
inside.
The point, though, you know, like the grayscale life, to drain all the color out of the world to where you barely look alive. And if you're lucky, just for a couple seconds, you'll fall into this realm of pure language where you can become godlike.
Weiß ich nur Dunkles zu sagen.
Walking around, sun's out, you know, gonna get that Whopper. Hit up Goodwill, see if they got any flowery dresses.
As if you're anything more than just a shadow still.